are very pleased that you are here, Agnes Heller. We have met a couple of times in Budapest, you and me, and we started to talk to each other through our common friend, Georg Klein.
So, put it bluntly, liberal democracy is not natural in Europe. There were very few years in Europe and modern European history where the majority of European states were characterized by liberal democracy. And there were far more years in European history where it was characterized by dictatorships, by autocratic dictatorships, by military dictatorships, by totalitarian dictatorships. Think it over. Nazism, Bolshevism, fascism. The population is not used to liberal democracy. It's not natural. It's not natural that we are a constitutional change. It's not natural that we listen to the opinion of others. It's not natural that others are like us, even if they are different from us. And the lack of the tradition of liberal democracy makes the situation of Europe difficult. Less difficult in Western Europe, less difficult in Central Europe, because they have at least already 50, 60 year continuous tradition in liberal democracy, more difficult in Southern Europe and even more difficult in Eastern Europe. To know the history, to face the tradition is very important in order to be able to face them, to see what are the alternatives of tomorrow.